Hello and welcome or welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how I made this delicious, rich and of course mouthwatering okra soup. This okra soup has the perfect balance in richness and consistency. That is, it's not too thick and at the same time it's not too soupy. So without much ado, let's get down to it. For the ingredients, we have some okra fingers. We also have our protein of choice, which is cowfoot, beef, shaki or tripe, but you can also use whatever meat you have. I'll also be using some ponmo or cow skin, which I've already parboiled to get rid of the nasty smell. And here we have some dried fish and stockfish, and some leftover prawns I have in my freezer. We'll also be using locust beans, crayfish powder, cameroon pepper, salt, stock cubes or maggi. And also some red bell peppers, scotch bonnet, chilli peppers and onions. I also have a handful of spinach and of course red palm oil. So now let's get started. To start out, we'll transfer the cowfoot, shaki, beef and stockfish into a pot, and then we'll be seasoning with some minced onions, crushed stock cubes or maggi, some salt and a bit of cameroon pepper. I'll stir this and let it steam in its own juice for about 10 minutes on medium heat. After about 10 minutes, we'll stir and add enough water to cover the meat or enough to cook the meat until tender. Depending on the type of meat you'll be using for your okra soup, some will cook faster than others. Like in my case, it's the beef, shaki and stockfish. I'll check to be sure they are tender and take them out, leaving the cow food behind. To that, I'll add the pre-cooked ponmo or cow skin. I'll add some water, some salt and seasoning if needed and cook until tender. Now they are fully cooked, so I'll take them out from the stock and set both the meat and the stock aside for later use. Now we'll cut some of the washed okra fingers by chopping off the top and making one or two symmetrical cuts along the length of the okra and then chopping them in bulk or as you feel comfortable with. We'll also be blending about 5 to 6 okra fingers with a little water. This will be used to give the soup more viscosity or drawness. I like to add a little bit of spinach to my okra soup, but it's optional, so you can leave it out if you want to. And for the peppers, we'll grind them coarsely so that it can give the soup a pop of color. After prepping all these ingredients, it's time to cook the okra soup. We'll now heat up about a cup of palm oil. Then we add some chopped onions and fry for like 1 to 2 minutes. We'll add in the iru or locust beans and stir for another 2 minutes. Also be adding our crayfish powder and stir continuously for about 10 to 20 seconds so that it doesn't burn. So now we add in our blended pepper mix and add some crushed stock cubes or maggi. We'll fry a bit and let it simmer for 10 minutes. After about 10 minutes, we'll go ahead and add the cooked assorted meat and stockfish and stir until it's well combined with the pepper sauce. So then we add our meat stock, stir and let it come to a boil. You can use less stock if you want your okra soup very thick and crunchy. I like mine in between, not too runny and not too thick. You know, if we call it okra soup, let it look like soup now, Abby. So now add the clean dry fish and we'll stir gently. Now we're going to add the blended okra and mix well into the soup. The blended okra is going to give the soup that viscosity or drawness that is ascribed to okra soup. As you can see, our soup is very soupy and dry now. Now we'll add the chopped okra and also mix to combine. When it comes to cooking, always play to your preference. Some people like their soup thick, meaty and crunchy, while some don't. Some like theirs very viscous, soupy and slimy, while some don't. While some also like their okra without any crunch. But feel free to adjust the ingredients and cooking time to your taste and preference. So now I'm going to add a handful of sliced spinach. Remember, this is optional, so you don't have to add it to your okra soup. We'll also taste for salt and seasoning and adjust if needed. I like my okra soup with some soup to dip in, but at the same time crunchy and thick, so I'll leave it to cook for about 3 to 5 minutes. And finally, I'll add the fresh prawns and cook for about 3 minutes. And our okra soup is ready. Thank you so much for watching. I truly hope you enjoyed this video and please give us a thumbs up, subscribe, share with a friend and also say hi in the comment section below. I truly appreciate it. See you in the next video. Bye bye.